It's your girl Asante. I make videos that help you move consciously and creatively through life. And welcome to my bedroom slash office slash studio. Now, some people say not to work in your bedroom, and I say if you have the luxury of having a separate workspace, then go for it, honey. I, on the other hand, am literally working right next to my bed. I live with a roommate, so I wanna be in a place where I know I can close the door. I sometimes work at the dining room table, but I need my actual setup to be in a space where I have peace and quiet and privacy, and I know that I can focus in whenever necessary, take any video calls I need, really listen to video and audio, which is a large part of my job. I designed the layout of this room to be a vlogging space. That was a consideration when I moved in. I usually vlog sitting on my bed, so I needed the bed to be the main thing in front of the window so I can get my natural light. So that's why my bed is in front of the window and my desk winds up being in kind of a dark corner. Now before, I'd always had my bed in the corner of a room in order to maximize floor space, so I originally had my bed like right next to the window. But I realized aesthetically with how things look in front of the camera lens, I wanted more space between the camera and the bed, and also between my bed and the background behind me. That way, you know, my face looks less distorted because it's not as close to the lens, and I can get a little slight depth of field in the background. So that's why I moved my bed to the middle of the room. What that did was separate my room into two zones, my personal zone and my work zone. So on this side of the room is where I'm getting dressed in the morning. It's the side of the bed that I go into to sleep at night. It's where I'm doing my meditation, my daily dance outs. And the other side is where I'm doing my work, both my personal work and for my day job. It's the side of the bed that I vlog from. And if I want a more loungy place to work, I'll basically treat this side of the bed as a couch and lie up against the foot of the bed. So it's different from the head of the bed where I sleep. This is a side where I can like relaxedly work. And if I actually want to relax, I'm usually doing that in the living room on the actual couch. So I have three work areas, one against each wall, except for the closet wall. On this wall, there's the window, and then there's my desk in the corner. This is my main desk. It's also where I store most of my supplies. And this was where I was doing all of my work pre-pandemic. Against that wall is my smaller desk. It was originally just to house art supplies and to give some empty table space to lay things down on. But when I realized I was gonna be in here all day, every day, I wanted to work by the light. And while there's not a ton of space, I realized there was enough space for the basics. So I set this up a couple months ago, and it's just the place where I work on my laptop. And this, where you all are perched right now, is my standing desk, i.e. my dresser. This is me trying to add some variety to my workspaces, some different angles and situations throughout the day. It's healthier not to sit for hours and hours and hours on end, and I realized this was the perfect height for a standing desk, so I cleared it off, and now that's how I use it. So this is my daytime desk. This is where I'm working a lot, especially with my day job. Under the desk are taller production supplies, so stands, tripods, the case for my ring light, etc. And then I have my office chair with these super fuzzy foam arm pads attached. Having armrest pads make these so much more comfortable, and that was a criteria for me selecting an office chair. It had to be one with arms that I could put the thing around. And then on my desk, I have my essential tools, so laptop, of course. I have my laptop stand, which I was slacking on getting a laptop stand for the longest time, but it makes such a huge difference. It's so much better for your posture if you can have your laptop eye level and not be looking down, slouching, and having a lot of back and neck pain associated with that. So it's helpful to be able to sit up, and I definitely don't have as much back pain. And shout out to my teddy bears that live behind my laptop stand. They were here first next to my bed, so they get to stay. And I have my wireless Apple keyboard and trackpad over mouse all day. And then I have this beanbag wrist cushion, which is potentially the best free swag that I've ever gotten at a vendor booth. Highly recommend, again, to have better posture, reduce the pain and cramping in your wrist, and also for me, I'm avoiding the edge of this table. I also keep my blue light glasses here, which are a must. These help me to avoid getting a headache from staring at a screen all day, and it helps block the blue light at night, so you have a better time falling to sleep and your body can wind down a lot better. So Umizato actually reached out and sent these to me. They're super chic, very fashionable, a lot nicer than some of the cheaper glasses that I'd had before, and they fit really well. They're so comfortable. So, you know, I'm looking cute on these video calls, which is important because we're living our lives through video calls these days. That's how you see anyone. So you gotta look your best, but also block the blue light from the screen. So Umizato is not sponsoring this video, but they did give me a coupon code. So if you wanna up your blue light glasses game, I will link to them in the description with my coupon code. Next, I have my iPad second monitor, which when I realized that you could use your iPad as a second monitor, I was stoked. Because as you can see, I do not have space for a second monitor, but it is really helpful to be able to like put your to-do list off to one side or put a document to take notes off to the side if you're listening to someone over here. So if you're on a Mac, you can use Sidecar to set this up. And now my second monitor is my iPad on a phone stand on a Girl Scout tin. Kablam! I have two cup holders because I often have a drink and a green smoothie. It's almost time for my green smoothie now, actually. Keep a little notepad and a pen tucked behind here if I want to take physical notes on actual paper. It happens sometimes. All of my to-do lists are in Notion and all of my notes are in Evernote, so I don't usually need it, but it's good to have. And then over here are my cute little Pomodoro timers. They're hourglasses that are not an hour. So I don't know, half hour glasses, 15 minutes? I don't know if it, is there a name? But they're super cute. This one is 5 minutes for a little 5 minute break. This one is 15 minutes and the red is 30 minutes. What I prefer about these is that when I do Pomodoro on my phone, I'm seeing the countdown happen, right? And even if I turn my screen off, I'm always tempted to check the countdown and see how many minutes I have left. I tried doing it with a kitchen timer too, and you always hear the tick, 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 tick. And all that is stressful and it's distracting. Like, that's the opposite purpose of doing Pomodoros. With these, it's just, are you within the time frame or are you not? There's no ticking time going by, there's no countdown, it's just focused or break time. What I also prefer is that I can actually stay in flow when this is up because there's not some big disruption to say, hey, your time is up, pull you out of the task that you've now gotten to focus in. Sometimes I'm in the flow to the point where I forget about the timer and I look over and it's run up. And so that lets me know that I can go take a break, but it's also nice not to be interrupted in the middle of flow just because I'm 30 minutes into a task. And then these drawers hold my production supplies and art supplies. So the bottom three are for camera equipment, production equipment, things like batteries, audio stuff, smaller tripods, and the top three are for visual art supplies. So I have some paints, some brushes, stuff like that. I have my lovely pothos plant to keep me company. And I actually have four plants in this room. I don't kill plants. That's been a nice discovery in the past year or so. Another reason why I like sitting here primarily to work during the day is because of the light and the view that people have of me during video calls. From this corner, I look really well lit for the little webcam, and I have some of my art and whatnot in the background. For any calls that I have in the evening, I've perched a lamp on the top of these shelves so it lights me from above, which is more flattering. And so that lamp being strong enough right above my laptop is enough to get me through evening video calls as well. And this is my Petra Croton. She's the newest addition to my space and she's so pretty and vibrant. It sparks joy. So that's my daytime desk and this is my primary desk. This is my main desk, which is basically my storage desk. Any tool that I might need on a regular basis is within an arm's reach. Over to the side of the desk, I have these really cute filing drawers. I was so excited when I got them from the Container Store. I got to the point where I had enough records and statements and information I wanted to refer to and like handouts from conferences, educational reference materials, that having them in their own whole drawer allowed me to have that material easily referenceable. And I like a lot of the concepts from David Allen's Getting Things Done, and he's big on having a filing system so that you can easily put something into reference and take basically no time to process all the papers and materials that you collect throughout the day. On top of the filing drawers is my printer with a dust cover over it. The dust cover is definitely something that I learned I needed when my printer kept having dust all over it because I don't use it that much. So the dust cover really does keep it clean, because when I need the printer to like print out a page, it would be such a hassle to have to trek out to FedEx, Kinko's, or whatever. Above the printer, I have two trays. The bottom one is a waiting on tray. I think what's in there now is a notice about something that's about to come in the mail. Could also be keeping, you know, receipts from things that I'm not sure whether I'm gonna return or not, shipping notices or tracking information, stuff like that. And the top tray is for things that are associated with to-do list items. One reason that I got those two trays was so that I could separate those types of items from my inbox. This is my physical inbox, and so any papers or mail or things that I collect throughout the week go right into here, and I can process this about once a week. And I can get this to zero because anything that like is dependent upon another action being taken, I could put in my waiting pile, or anything that's really a to-do item, I can put in the to-do pile. And then these trays are to hold things that I use often enough that they would sort of be lying around on my desk, but I don't want them to be out. So I chew a lot of gum. I try to chew gum instead of snacking because I'm a big snacker and I try to not snack as much. So I have gum, I have mints, I have a mail opener, I have converters that I use pretty often, and so that's what's in here. Anything that I want to easily reference can go here. And then I have my old blue light glasses, things to clean my glasses, a piggy bank, and then I have these files that I can easily and quickly access if I need to throw a new file into my filing cabinet. My personal laptop either lives here on the desk, or I can put it into this little bookcase. My pens are many, but they are organized into actual pens, markers and Sharpies, pencils, and then reserve pens. I have a stack of drawers for my hard drives, plugs and cables, and miscellaneous accessories. Up here are notepads and sticky notes, basic school supplies, scissors that I use all the time. I have painter's tape in here as well. Mailing supplies, envelopes, stamps, labels, my label maker, and then a couple more journals, binder clips, paper clips, stuff like that in this bin. Over here I have my index cards, which I can sometimes use for brainstorming, an easy button.
That was easy.
Which still works. Although, when do I ever push an easy button? What is ever easy these days? And then my bookcase, which has some writing implements, some bigger pads, my iSpy books, my go-to for having a hard surface to write on. Love these. And then on the top row, we have a lovely little plant number 3, and some things that are decor, maracas that I could shake if I wanted a break, and toys and doodads up here, which, who has time to play games? I don't, but I pretend that I do by having some at my desk. Pictures of friends and family on the walls with these fairy lights. And then I have this IKEA lamp, which is decorative and functional. And it's part of why it's a nice place to work in the evenings, because I have this lamp right on top of me lighting this dark corner as well as these fairy lights. So that helps. I love that I get so much vertical space with this desk. I think it's also from IKEA. Most of my furniture I actually inherited from previous housemates. So this I got in my first ever sublet. The person didn't want the furniture. She moved all the way out. So I've kept it ever since. But what I like about this shelf is that this becomes my riser for my laptop. So I can just put that here. All of a sudden, we are level. We have our chin up. Our posture is set. And we're ready to go. And then I'll just bring over my keyboard and whatnot and connect it to this bad boy. And now I'm gonna put you on the shelf. So on this wall, I have my calendar. I have continued to jog most every day. Very proud of myself. I used to post routines and like mantras on this wall as well, but I do most of that stuff in Notion, and I find that's way more effective for me actually seeing things every day, or seeing them however often I want to see them. If you put something up on a wall, after a short time, it becomes commonplace and you don't even notice it anymore. So in Notion, I'm really surfacing things when they're relevant, and so I use that as my system. And bulletin board, you know, some nice pictures, some professional events, a couple reminders to myself of things that I don't need to like actually see and notice every day, but are just good like grounding things for me to come back to. And if I wanted to organize things on a whiteboard by days of the week, I could do that here. I used to use that. I'm not using it a ton anymore. Just kind of brings the whole layout together, if nothing else, you know? Tucked under my desk is a small shredder.
Oh, hey, it's my diploma.
A stool that I often use to kick my feet up, but it's also just really multi-purpose. Also say hi to my smiley face piggy bank, which I think has Mardi Gras beads in it. And a file box. This is what I was using before I realized I needed more file space and got the full drawers. And this one is labeled, so I know exactly what's in it. Then I have a makeshift system to organize my cables and a little box so that anything that I'm charging doesn't have to actually be on the ground. And then I have some lesser used supplies behind me, including refills of printer paper, still within arm's reach. And I don't have two office chairs, so this one is super simple. Again, something I just picked up for free with a pillow that I sewed several years ago, needs a restuff. but this is what I sit on, usually for short periods of time.
If I know I'm gonna sit here editing for a long time, then I'll go ahead and switch the chairs and bring the fancy office chair over here. So that's my main desk. Again, really using that vertical space. And speaking of vertical,
welcome to the standing desk.
So my standing desk is a dresser. It is a tall dresser, and when I realized it was the right height, I cleared off a lot of the unsightly dresser stuff, which is tucked right here. I got a little plant from Whole Foods because it's cute, and I got a standing mat to save my feet. And when I say it saves my feet, wow, standing mat changes the game, okay? It's also nice because I have my little pictures on the wall. This is part of the view that people see on video calls when I'm over in that corner at my daytime desk. So this is how my dresser normally looks. I come over here and get ready in the morning, and I keep it pretty clear so that when I decide I want to work standing for a little bit, I can just bring over my stand, my laptop, my keyboard, my trackpad, and bada boom, we're set. We're ready to go. Alright, so again, not space for much, but space enough for the basics. So that's my home bedroom office setup. As you can probably tell, I love little productivity gadgets and gizmos, so if you have any suggestions, drop them in the comments. And check out the description for a couple of links to the things that I mentioned. If you like my videos, then you can subscribe and you can support my videos on Patreon. Huge shout out to my Patreon patrons. Y'all are making this channel possible. As always, remember to live spiritedly and think creatively, and I will see you next time.